Restrooms are to the back of the hall downstairs. Additional accessible bathrooms are located on the main level in the school building. Please take a moment to silence your electronic devices. For the courtesy of everyone in attendance and on stage, we ask that you remain seated and only enter and exit during applause or a break in the program. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And welcome to our annual Mother's Day concert. Happy Mother's Day to all our moms and grandmoms and people who care for others as if they were moms. We are very glad to have you with us today on this special day for you and a special day for us, as it is our last concert of the season. Our first work was a less than often performed overture by Giuseppe Verdi. You may know his overtures from other operas such as Aida and La Traviata and Nabucco, among others. This opera from which the overture comes, the Sicilian Vespers, was based on an actual historical event in 1282 when the people of Sicily rebelled against their French rulers, and it started a war that lasted 20 years. As an opera, Verdi had some early success with it. It didn't really last very long, and it kind of fell out of the repertoire fairly quickly. But as is often the case, the overture sometimes outlasts the larger work, and I think this is one of his best. Our next work is a short concert work by French composer Emmanuel Chabrier. He's known for particularly exuberant works. He was a very high-energy composer, and it usually is often his works recognized other countries and cultures. His most famous work is probably España for orchestra. He's known for very kind of quirky orchestrations and sudden highs and lows in terms of character, and gives us a few surprises along the way. Here to conduct Joyeuse Marche is HYSO conductor apprentice, co-principal cellist, and Pittsford Sutherland senior Amy Funk. Our next work was written just last year by Rochester-based composer Steve Danyew. It is his, I think it's fair to say, his musical statement on the effects of climate change and humankind's inability to address it before it's too late. There are three segments to the work, and each is accompanied by a short poem written by Steve's wife, Ashley Danyew. The first is called Percussion of Heat and Fire, and the poem is this. Flames flicker and curl like oil on water. The air is thick with heat and smoke. Black trees bend like paper silhouettes against a bronze sky, burning into the night. The second section is called Water Corral. Stretching over the shoreline, eroding, erasing. Dark like blue ink. Rippled like velvet draped over the land, disappearing in the dark. And the third section is called Quiet. The end of nature. The world is quiet, enveloped in emptiness, wrapped in silence. The lush landscape now barren of fading memory. Not even the wind remains. We are honored to be one of the first orchestras to perform this work, and I'm sure that it will endure as a poignant statement on humanity's inhumanity to nature. This is Elegy for the End of Nature. As you may remember, we hold a concerto competition each year for our musicians, and the winners earn an opportunity to perform with us in their February or May concerts. Yes, thanks. You get to make room for a very large instrument. So our winner has earned an opportunity to perform with us in either the February or May concerts. And back in February, we heard a gorgeous performance by cellist Joanna Frank of Brooks Cold Nivre, and we're in for another treat today. Here to perform the third movement from Emmanuel Séjourné's concerto for Marimba and Strings, HYSO principal percussionist, Pittsford Sutherland senior, and two-time winner of our competition, Danyew Kinney.
Thank you.
Before we play and perform our final work, a few thank yous. First of all, I would like to thank Hochstein's administration, faculty, and staff for the support of our orchestra program and all of its musicians, from the concertino strings through Sinfonia and Philharmonia to HYSO. We have a very unique program in this area, and we're so fortunate to remain so strong because of their support. I especially want to thank Ensemble Coordinator Diane Smith for her tireless efforts on our behalf. Please join me in thanking you. I'd like to thank, of course, all of the area's public and private music educators and studio teachers who help cultivate musicianship and guide these musicians to be the amazingly skilled people that they are. I'm especially grateful to our coaches that worked with us throughout the season, Pia Liptak, Diane Smith, Jeremy Stoner, John Rowland, Anchi Lin, Olita Pomero, Kathy Kemp, and Corey Palmer for sharing their expertise with us throughout the year. The facilities and stage staff here at Hochstein is unrivaled. They keep this beautiful building in tremendous shape, and they make all of our jobs much easier by anticipating the things we need on a regular basis. I particularly want to recognize Danyew for his superb stage management and attention to detail each week. Also, Hochstein's facilities director is not just a marvel here at Hochstein, but he plays a crucial role on our tours, of which we just returned for one. From setting up our concert venues, to fixing instruments, to being the keeper of the first aid kit, to crafting emergency concert clothing out of gaffer's tape, or just being a soft shoulder to lean on when you don't feel well or you just miss home. He is the heart of our tours, and that was no more evident than this year. Please join me in thanking Mr. Randy Kemp. Our orchestra manager is a master organizer, earnest communicator, meticulous planner, and a nurturing presence for our students. She's also someone who keeps me updated and organized when I need it most. She also manages our tours and makes sure that everything is completed on our end so that our travel company can do their jobs. She is a huge part of what makes what we do here very special, and I can't imagine HYSO without her. Please join me in thanking our wonderful orchestra manager, Mrs. Ruth Gates. Finally, before I recognize our students, I want to recognize someone for whom this is her last HYSO concert as president and executive director of the Hochstein School. For the past 30 years, and another 13 years on faculty before that, she has been a calm, steadfast, and crucial advocate for Hochstein and the entire arts community here in Rochester. During her tenure, her vision and support for all of the offerings here has helped to make Hochstein one of the most important community arts schools in the nation. I am personally grateful for her confidence in me and our program, and I join many people in our community with wishes for a restful and blissful retirement. Please join me in thanking Dr. Peggy Quackenbush. This group of students may not have been sure what to expect when we started the season. We came together in September after a year with split orchestra offerings last year due to the pandemic, and I think it would have been reasonable for us to assume that we would have needed a little extra time to kind of coalesce and become a cohesive orchestra once again. And boy, did they reject that notion. Not only did they quickly learn how to work together and with each other to create a beautiful musical product, but they formed a rapport almost instantly with each other that I think they needed and welcomed after a year of uncertainty. I have such tremendous admiration for all these students, for their poise, character, and certainly their abilities, and I'm so glad that I get to work with many of them again next year. We must say goodbye for now, though, to our superb senior class. Whether they've been with us for 1 year or seven, their leadership and guidance of our younger players has been invaluable. Each of them is a lovely, kind, and generous person, and they all represent themselves, their families, their schools, and Hochstein so well. I'm going to read the list of our seniors. As you hear your name, seniors, please stand. But I would ask you all to hold your applause until the entire list has been read. Eliana Alois, heading to Brown University. Prothom Bomare, George Washington University. Addie Kenny, U of R and Eastman School of Music. Anna Saraceletti, Cornell University. Audrey Chung, Cornell University. Caroline Darling, University of Rochester. Amy Feng, Harvard University. Julia Finkbeyer, Duquesne University. Danyew Kinney, Northwestern University. Sarah Coates, Northeastern, Stony Brook, or Binghamton. Sean Lee, Johns Hopkins University. Hannah Wu, we'll take a gap here. Elijah Malik, Binghamton University. Selena Nguyen, University at Buffalo. Matthew O'Hara, SUNY Fredonia. Lily Odiambo, Howard University. Kate Polanski, SUNY Fredonia. Kendall Pask, Duquesne University. Cole Pringle, pursuing trumpet performance. Catherine Runyon, Grove City College. Emma Smith, SUNY Albany. David Hsu, University of Rochester. Gabe Vitt, Hobart and William Smith Colleges. And Jesse Ward, Cornell University. Did I miss any of you seniors? The HYSO class of 2022. It is one of Copland's quintessential American-sounding or American West-sounding works, and along with Rodeo and Appalachian Spring that he wrote around the same time. The ballet tells a semi-fictional story of Billy the Kid, the notorious outlaw. After an introduction, you'll hear, which kind of expresses the expanse of the prairies and the American West, we hear music that kind of accompanies life in a small town. Later, in that same scene, we encounter Billy as a young boy, where he witnesses the murder of his mother during a bar brawl. He then kills his mother's assailants with a knife. Some years in the future, we experience a card game at night under the stars with Billy and his fellow outlaws. This quickly devolves into a gunfight with his once friend, Sheriff Packer. Billy's captured, and we hear a celebration at one of the saloons with some kind of out-of-tune, amateurish sounding music. Billy escapes with his young lover, but is caught one last time and killed by the authorities. The introductory music returns with an air of hope and optimism. We hope you enjoy Aaron Copland's Billy the Kid.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. If you'll indulge us, one more thing, please. The traditional end of season encore for this orchestra is from Sir Edward Elgar's Enigma Variations. This piece has the larger work is really a fascinating tribute to friendship, and it's basically a theme of variations, and each of the movement was named for a grand acquaintance, someone who was special to Elgar. But only he and the dedicatee knew who the movements were for. Some were just initials, some were symbols. This particular one that we're going to play has a unique story. Elgar's publisher was the last name Jaeger. And in German, the name Jaeger means hunter. In the Old Testament, there is a prominent figure named Nimrod, and Nimrod was also known as a hunter. So in dedication to his friend Jaeger, he named this piece Nimrod. And it is a testament to friendship, community, everything that we try to strive for here at HYSO and Hochstein. And as we send our seniors off and end our season, we couldn't think of a more fitting way each year than to close with this piece. We hope you enjoy this beautiful work. This is Nimrod from Elgar's Enigma Variations.